By popular request, this is my collection of tenant ties. A gentleman asked me to review my Magnoli ties, so I figured I'll throw in my genuines as well. So, let's get to it. We will start with the gorgeous and ever-popular swirl tie. This is actually what prompted me to do this in the first place. The one you see here in the back just arrived. So, because it's new, I'll do a review on all of them and just save you all a lot of time and trouble. The swirl tie was his first and still the most popular replica because of End of Time and 11th Hour. Both doctors have worn the tie, and it's really is a beautiful tie. So it's the most popular, the most worn, and I'm betting, review or not, you all either own one or are waiting for one to come in the mail. So I'll tell you what to expect. This is the darker blue. He calls it French blue. It's darn near black. This is Magnoli's. It was my latest tie of his. So this is the first version he did, which you'll see is a lot lighter, and the pattern is a bit wider for the tie. So he's adjusted that in the probably third run, I believe, this darker one is, from, I believe this was the second run that I first found it. And now, I believe this is the fourth run, and it's still in its plastic, so we will pull that out. It's a lovely safety wrapper. Yes, it is fresh from the packaging. And you'll see it's still lighter than, of course, the blackish color, but darker than the second run. So he's made that change there. It's a slightly darker color, but the weave is darn near the same for the pattern. So I think he's happy with the pattern weave. The Christian LaCroix symbol, of course, is still matching up pretty well. And it's the silk, so it has that great shine to it when it switches through the colors and it bends in the light. So those are my three swirl style ties. And I hear he's doing another revision of the swirl, because if people buy ties, he will run out of stock and reload them. So when he changes them or has to reorder them, he usually makes improvements as well. This is my original duffer tie with the blue strap back. And this is Magnoli's replica. As you can see, these things, it's the same tie. He even went so far as to do the same pattern on the lining. I mean, he made this as good a replica as he possibly could. Even did the strap for you. It's not just a blue ribbon. He used the lining material to make the ribbon on the back. Now, all the sources have come out that the narrow tie, which is actually 1 centimeter more narrow, is the truly accurate tie. So if you want, you can just split this little seam in the back here and pull this in 1 centimeter and just taper it all the way up, and suddenly you have a screen accurate tie. Congratulations. But if you don't want to pay $100 online for the duffer, and for some reason you can't get it on Debenhams' website, which if you can't, I'll send you the link. So just ask, don't pay $100 for a tie. You can order this directly from Debenhams, or you can order this from Magnoli for $60. All of his ties are $60. Let's see. This is the never-worn tie. They're going around online. They're still fairly cheap. So if you want, I think you just search tenant tie, and yeah, on the tenant suit blogspot, there's a link for it. And again, if you ask, I'll send you the link. But this is the one from the auction that was bought for Tenet, but has never been in an episode. But it's in the same color scheme, brown and blue mixes. He usually does floral patterns, but a brown, dark brown and blue tie is the Tenet standard. So if you want to buy your own, keep that in mind when you buy them. This is the Tenet tie. He just named it after the actor because I believe this was his first... first or second attempt at a tenant tie. If you want to look at the original draft, if you look up his tenant coat, tied around the neck of the model there is his first draft, which looks dramatically different from this. So you can see all the changes that Magnoli goes through to make his ties. This was the first one, first version of it I bought from him. I think my third tie from Magnoli itself. And this is the revision of it. So as you can see, he lightened the brown a little bit for the revision, which is pretty rare. He usually goes too light and then has to darken it, but this time he went too dark and had to make it a little bit lighter. And this one is absolutely gorgeous. I love this tie. It was shipped to me by accident because I had ordered the swirl tie, and I screwed up the wording and he sent me the wrong tie. So because he sent me the wrong tie, I kept it and just ordered another tie because it really is a gorgeous tie. I love that one. But the color, it's darn near spot on. That's a really good replica. If you want to order a tenant tie, it's just called the tenant tie. So highly recommend that one. Went through a really good revision. This is the, I think, second or third run of it, which was really close in pattern. And then fourth run, he's got the color really, really good. Now we come to my favorite. This is his Shakespeare tie. And I love it. I've seen the actual tie, the Armani tie. And this is lighter and doesn't have the undertone of blue in it. So it's the color, again, needs another revision. But I just love this tie. It's the most popular in episodes and all of the promo photos. He did most of his promo photos in this tie. So if you want the most popular screen-worn tie, grab the Shakespeare tie. And I love it. And I think he's going to do a revision on that one as well. So if you buy them all up, we'll get a shiny new version. But yeah, gorgeous tie, very versatile. I love the pattern. They call it the egg tie on the show because of the odd shape to the pattern here. And it's got the little, it looks like a yolk when you see the pattern behind it. The off-colored, darker weft of it. So yeah, great tie, love that one. This is his Utopia tie. His least popular tie, actually, and I'm not sure why. It's got a great little pattern to it. It's got the lighter blue with the brown, and this is a pinkish hue to it. So a lot of the rose costumes use a lot of pink and blue. So to go, if you have a rose to go with, this is a great one to match, and it's a much lighter brown. So in dark hallways and all your interior shots, which is where most of your conventions are held, this one will actually look very, very nice, and it'll actually show up in the photo, so people will know you have a patterned tie as opposed to just something really, really dark like most of his other ties. So Utopia, not incredibly popular, but a really nice tie. So grab you one if you want more replicas. This one I wanted first. This is the one I actually first emailed Magnoli about and asked him to make. This is his lantern tie from The Idiot's Lantern. Worn once, only episode it ever appeared in, only time you ever see Tennant in the tie. I don't think he even did a promo in this tie. It just appeared on one episode and disappeared. But since so many ladies do the Idiot's Lantern rose dress and jacket and hairstyle, and they love the shoes and the whole thing, it's just, it was really cute outfit of rose, and the ladies love to do it. So if you have a rose, then you probably need this tie, because this is the only one that goes with that particular rose. And don't forget to do the sweep back on your hair as well. He had a whole different look for that one, and this is the tie for it. I love the pattern, because I really hate most the fleur-de-lis and the, I forget the name of the pattern, but they're desperately overused in ties. So to get a nice swirl-style pattern, but without using the fleur-de-lis or the, I forget that 60 pattern now. But it's very, very rare to get this flowing style without using those two patterns. So it's nice to see, and I just love this tie. It's a really good tie. And here is his Santarin tie, which, again, absolutely gorgeous. It's his only tie for the blue suit too. So if you have a blue suit, go ahead and buy it. Absolutely nothing wrong with this tie. It has the great wood carved pattern. You see the little gap in between the blue there, where you can see the red in between it. So when the light hits it, it just does great things. This looks really good in natural light. So if you're outside, I just
absolutely gorgeous tie to wear. But in general, it's just beautiful. I love that tie. No reason not to own that tie. Even if you hate red, it's still the blue in it just makes it gorgeous. I absolutely love that tie. So that's my tie review. Questions, comments, concerns, or any updates you'd like or want to post, or if there's something I missed, feel free to ask and mention it. But yeah, this is my tie collection. I'm proud of it. All right, thanks for watching.